ඒකයි බය නැතුව මම Nokia Android smartphone එක ඕන කෙනෙකුට ගන්න කියන්නේ.
සමගා අලුත් වන Nokia.
Given the confusion surrounding the Swiss embassy abduction incident in the past week, Minister of Foreign Affairs Dinesh Gunawardana and Secretary to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs Ravinath Aryasinghe held a media briefing today to state the government's position and clear up some of the confusion surrounding it.
The Foreign Ministry summoned all the high commissioners and ambassadors. We explained to them the truth behind the present investigation on the complaint received by the ambassador on an employee of his embassy being victimized according to him and abducted according to him on the 25th of last month. We met the ambassador on the 27th early morning when it was brought to our notice. We also have requested that the embassy cooperate by asking this person to make a statement with the CID. The investigation needs also a statement or a complaint by the so-called victim. Up to now, this has not been given by the victim. Instead, the request has come to fly her and her family out of the country to Switzerland for medical treatment by bringing a hospital plane that is available, which they had tried to bring, but we have advised that to follow the normal procedures adopted by an embassy. Most of the matters mentioned by the embassy and their officials have been properly checked by the police, and we have explained to the ambassador that they have very little truth in the main allegation. That is the situation. Attorney General has made an application to court. The court gave order yesterday, allowing a statement to be recorded, and until then, to prevent the so-called complainant to be leaving the country. And we feel this is all another step of misinformation, spreading falsehood, throwing mud at the political leadership of our country. Just before elections, the same thing in different form was campaigned. The country rejected it. Police and all investigation institutions are on the job. They have found enough information. All that shows that the so-called victim's complaint has no standing. There was our ambassador also has traveled to Bern and met the Swiss Foreign Ministry and placed all these facts. Also the Swiss Foreign Ministry finally also conveyed to the ambassador that if the person can be brought by the hospital plane, the treatment could be given. Her protection has been guaranteed. Her family, relatives' protection has been guaranteed. And we have, our police has taken all necessary steps to give the necessary security to the people concerned. I hope the media also cooperates because a lot of falsehood, a lot of misinformation has spread and is bad for the country. We must understand we have come out of a lot of such misinformation that we should give more the truth available to the people rather than various other agendas that are tried to be worked by people who have been defeated by the people. Now, what was requested by the ambassador was that the person be given protection, but she was not available to in any place to be given protection after the ambassador brought this to our notice. Secondly, the family also has moved out and we are unable to give protection, but we have assured that all the protection that is necessary to the residents and the complex where she had lived, her family has stayed, will be given protection. But the person must come. Person must make the complaint. We are virtually convinced on this matter to the Swiss government also. Our position, our law, Honorable State Minister stated, the law is clear. A statement has to be made or a complaint has to be made by the so-called victim.
What was given to the Foreign Ministry was just the fact that there has been an alleged abduction. Subsequently, the embassy has provided the CID, which was investigating this case, with a sequence of events. As we said on Sunday in our statement, and I will quote that paragraph again, while the embassy had not presented the alleged victim to be interviewed by the law enforcement officials, despite their request to do so, based on the information provided by the Swiss mission on Friday 29th November, the investigation was nevertheless conducted. The ambassador was presented, this on Sunday, with clear evidence that the sequence of events and timeline of the alleged incident, as formally presented by the Swiss mission on behalf of the alleged victim to the CID did not in any way correspond with the actual movements of the alleged victim on that date, and we are talking of Monday, 25th November, as borne out by witness interviews and technical evidence, including Uber records, CCTV footage, telephone records, and GPS data. Given by a doctor in Switzerland who has on video link examined the patient, so-called patient, and has made some observations, we are not aware, we have not been presented any evidence of any local doctor.
Maxis, number one tie in Sri Lanka.